Good morning, children. Welcome to sixth and last session of the chapter Linear Regression. Now, today's session, we will do theory part of this chapter. Of course, the questions from both point of view, 2 marks or 3 marks, can be asked in the theory part only of this chapter. So, let us start. Properties of regression coefficients. This is the first topic of today's session. 3 properties are very simple. Number 1, R and B have the same sign. R that is correlation coefficient and B that is regression coefficient. Now these both have always same sign. If positive, then both will be positive, and if negative, then both will be negative. So this is your first property of regression coefficient. Second, that is independent of changing of origin but not of scale. If you remember, the same property, it was there in correlation coefficient. Of course, there it was free from changing of origin as well as scale. Here it is independent of changing of origin but not of scale. What is the meaning of these two? See, it's independent of changing of origin. That shows that when we solve the sum with the help of shortcut method, that time u x minus a and v, how we find that was y minus b. In that case, b x y is equal to b u and v. Now this shows that, or this is called what? Changing of origin, where when you can add or you can subtract, but this value of b, that remains same. That is b x y is equal to b u v, but not of scale. The meaning of this is what? That is, in this, at the place of this x minus a, if you remember, cx and cy, where we used to divide with common factor, whether it is x or y. Now, in that case, bxy can't be buv. If you remember in the formula, it was, we had taken this also, cy upon cx. Now, because of this reason only, it is not independent of scale. You simply, if you divide or if you multiply, then for that, the value of bxy won't be same as buv. We multiply with cy upon cx. So this is the reason that independent of changing of origin but not of scale. And last point, last property, regression line of y on x always passes through the point x bar and y bar. Now you know x bar and y bar both are averages, so always this regression line y on x passes through this point, that is x bar and y bar. So these are the 3 properties of regression coefficients. Now second topic is, that is difference between correlation and regression. 4 points are there. If question comes of 2 marks, you write all the 4 points, and if question comes of 3 marks, you write 3 points. Now let us go for the first difference. Now first difference is meaning. We know very well what is correlation. Correlation, that is a numerical measure of linear relationship between the variables, while regression is functional relationship. It is functional relationship and it helps us in estimating value of one variable for given value of another variable. So simple meaning of correlation and regression. Second difference is, that is R always lies between minus 1 to plus 1. While regression, now this regression coefficients, those are 2. One is byx, which we did, that is for y on x regression line, and another is, that is BXY, which is for X on Y regression line. Now in your syllabus it is only Y on X regression line, that is why we have done it one, that is B only, but actually it is BYX. So these two regression coefficients, from that one regression coefficient can be greater than 1, and another obviously it will be less than 1. So this is also the difference, that R lies between minus 1 to plus 1, while regression coefficient can be greater than 1, that is one regression coefficient. Third difference, it is independent from origin and scale, which already we discussed in last point also. And here regression, that is independent of origin but not of scale. Last point of difference, that is R, can be obtained from regression coefficients, while regression coefficient cannot be obtained from only R. If you remember in this formula, which last session, which short sums we did, in that one of the formula for finding B was, that is R into SY upon SX. So with the help of R we can obtain regression coefficients, but regression coefficients cannot be obtained from only R. So these are the four points of difference between correlation and regression. Last topic of this chapter, that is utility of study of regression, that is what are the uses of, why we study this regression, what are the uses of it. Four uses are, number one, to estimate value of dependent variable for a given value of independent variable, that is prediction formula. So this is, we can predict that value of X which we use, and based on that we use to find the estimated value of Y. So it is prediction formula. Second, to estimate probable change in value of dependent variable for a unit change in the value of independent variable. Here we estimate probable change in the value of which dependent variable for a unit which change is there in the value of independent variable. Third is, we can obtain R from regression coefficient. So this is also use of this regression, that we can find, we can obtain R. Last, that is widely used in problems of business, industry, economics, sociology, psychology, medicine, etc. In all these fields, this regression coefficient, it is useful to solve the problems of these all fields. So this way, these are the four main uses of study of regression. This is an end of this session. Thank you.